Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Welcome to a Microsoft Excel video. This video is going to discuss the difference between the markup versus margin. So this is great if you are an accounting student or just general business, you want to know how this works. So over in column A and B, I've already got this set up. Some item cost $8 for us. I'm going to do the math in my head. I want to mark it up 25%. 25% of $8 is $2. So therefore, the retail or selling price is $10. There's my cost at $8. So the Excel formula is the $10 minus the $8 right there. Markup and margin, one item they do have in common, they're always involving three items, and those never change. The selling price or retail price, the cost is the second item, and the third item is your profit. Where they differ is when you're dealing with the percentages. So I'm going to do the margin first. The margin is your profit divided by the selling price, so 20%, but your markup is still the profit. So that hasn't changed, but you divide by cost. So margin is dividing by the selling price, markup is dividing by the cost, and there you go right there. If you were looking, the margin percentage is sometimes called the gross margin percentage. I've seen it also as gross profit percentage. Either term is correct. If you are doing vertical analysis on an income statement, and I have a video, it is up in the top right corner of my vertical analysis, you'd be using the margin percentage, not the markup. Now, part two of this video, I want to show you that the margin percentage is always going to be less than the markup percentage, but that is okay. It's just how it works. If you notice, I've already got 20 and 25% in column B. So in this example, we've got a $10 price for an item. And then here are the different costs right here. So $10 minus 8, we've already done this one. So this next one, $10 minus 7 is $3 profit. $3 divided by the selling price of $10 is that 30%, by the way. I just typed it in here. But I want to show you how the margin percentage and the markup percentage differ, but it doesn't matter what the selling price is. So here we go. This is going to be G2 times the margin percentage, because that's going to give us the $2 profit, divided by G2 minus 1 minus E3. How does that sound? Sounds horrible because it's wrong. Let me do it real quick. G2 times. Now it sounds right. So there's your formula up in the formula bar right above column A and B right there. I do need to fix this formula. I need to make G2 an absolute cell reference. I'm pressing the F4 function key. Everything else can stay relative, meaning your E's can be relative. So here we go. Crosshairs. So at a 30% margin, our markup is 42.8%. And at a 50% margin, our markup is 100%. Let's talk about that last one real quick. If something costs $40 and you mark it up 100%, you're doubling the price. So that $40 is now an $80, but that's your markup 100%. But your margin is the 80 minus 40. To give you the $40 profit, the $40 profit divided by the retail price of $80 is 50%. What's cool about this? I'm over in G2. It does not matter what this retail price is. Those percentages will be the same. Anyway, I hope that helps. If you need help understanding the difference between the margin versus the markup, feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Feel free to ask me any comments or questions down below and ring the bell and all that other stuff. I appreciate your time. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.